Let me take you back 175 years. It's the spring of 1842. A young Vermonter, Libby Hyde Bailey, has made the risky move west to Michigan via the Erie Canal, bent on establishing his own farm and orchards. This desire lands him in southeastern Michigan, where he builds that family home and prize-winning orchard. This is not to confuse him with this Liberty Hyde Bailey, Jr., one of his sons. That Liberty, 36 years later, reversed his father's journey, traveling to East Lansing, enrolling at Michigan Agricultural College, and becoming its professor of horticulture. Bailey Jr. then traveled even farther east to Cornell University in Ithaca, New York, to lead its College of Agriculture to distinction. There, Liberty Hyde Bailey Jr., no longer a junior, would live out the rest of his years. Bailey was more, however, than a scientist, educator, administrator, and public figure. He was a philosopher, moralist, and visionary. This is how one past director of the L.H. Bailey Horatorium at Cornell described Bailey. Perhaps that is why his childhood home in South Haven is now a museum. And that is why I'm retracing Liberty Hyde Bailey's journey to Ithaca. Cue the music. I'm John Stempien, Director Emeritus of the Liberty Hyde Bailey Museum in South Haven, Michigan. My journey takes me to a small cottage on the eastern side of Cayuga Lake, just north of Cornell University. There, John Lindstrom, another former director of the Liberty Hyde Bailey Museum, is housing me for 3 nights as both of us go on the trail of Liberty Hyde Bailey. We're about to meet experts and professionals at an Ivy League school regarding a man arguably was a genius.
Thursday? What's today? July?
Who knows?
Water is boiling in Ithaca. Or is it Lansing? Whoa. Off of Cayuga River. Lake Cayuga. Water's boiling. Pesto is pestoing.
Pesto.
The best o' pesto.
Check this out.
When I met my wife, first word I said to her, pesto. That's what I said. Hey, how you doing?
Hi,
my name's Michelle. Hey, pesto. And she goes, oh my gosh, you're my husband. We're meant to be. It was weird.
That's pretty natural.
It was.
So what took Bailey's father weeks takes only hours for myself. To cap off the day on Cayuga Lake, I share with John another Bailey dream where him and I are doing research in a library's archive, coming across Bailey's essays in an anthology of nature writing. In this sense, the dream will become fulfilled, because tomorrow John has arranged for a full day of research on Cornell's campus. And here's where time and place begin their strange intersections. I had referred to this trip as a journey. But recently I came across a passage from the only published piece of fiction by Bailey called The Seven Stars. In it is this solitary sentence. Life, if worthwhile, is a quest, not merely a journey. The quest. Bailey had used this word before regarding his life pursuit of poems, saying, the more important part is the quest, is the meeting of people and the experiences you have on the way.
Totally. Yeah. And we got that book. What are we gonna get tomorrow?
I don't know, man. What kind of green book we're gonna find tomorrow. What kind of jewels we'll find tomorrow.
Good one.
Last night I dreamed I was Brooklyn on my Last night I dreamed I was Brooklyn on my own. Lord, I couldn't see the shadows all in my.